I previously mentioned that partial fractions is a great way of solving integrals involving rational functions as long as the denominator had more powers of x than the numerator. Now we're going to talk about what happens if this isn't true. What happens if the denominator has as many powers as the numerator has as many powers as the denominator, or as in this case, it has even more powers than the denominator? And the answer is that we can do a long division. We can rewrite this ratio as a polynomial plus a fraction. And the fraction is something that you can do partial fractions on, and the polynomial is easy to handle. So in this case, we're going to divide x to the fourth plus 0x cubed plus 0x squared plus 3 plus 2x plus 7, that's our numerator, and we're dividing that by x squared plus 3x plus 2. And the way you do long division with polynomials is the same as the way you do long division with numbers. It's just that instead of having a ones place, a tens place, a hundreds place, a thousands place, and a ten thousands place, you have a ones place, an x squared place, an x cubed place, an x to the fourth place. And you always, whenever doing the division, you always look at the leading term and divide it by the leading term here. So x to the fourth divided by x squared makes x squared. What do we subtract off? We have to subtract off x squared times this whole thing. So that's x to the fourth plus 3x cubed plus 2x squared. We subtract that off, and we get negative 3x cubed minus 2x squared plus 2x plus 7. Okay, negative 3x cubed divided by x squared gives us negative 3x. And we subtract off negative 3x cubed minus 9x squared minus 6x. And that gives us 7x squared plus 8x plus 7. 7x squared divided by x squared is 7. So we subtract off 7x squared plus 21x plus 14. And our remainder is negative 13x minus 7. So what we've just done is we've said that this fraction here is x squared minus 3x plus 7 with a remainder of negative 13x minus 7. In other words, it's x squared minus 3x plus 7 minus 13x plus 7 over the thing we're dividing by. And now this is something that we can do regular partial fractions on. We know how to integrate this part, it's just a polynomial, and this part we do regular partial fractions on. So this factors as x plus 1 times x plus 2. So we write the ratio as something over x plus 1 plus something over x plus 2. We cross multiply, and then we plug in the roots. We plug in x equals negative 1 and x equals negative 2. We plug in x equals negative 1, we get that negative 6 is a. When we plug in that x equals negative 2, we get that negative 19 is minus b. So b is 19. So this whole expression, and since we're subtracting it, we're going to get plus 6 over x plus 1 and minus 19 over x plus 2. So the whole expression is the integral of this bit, and this bit isn't hard. The integral of x squared is x cubed over 3. Integral of 3x is 3x squared over 2. Integral of 7 is 7x. 6 natural log of x plus 1. Negative 19 log of x plus 2. An arbitrary constant. And we are done.